So we began in 2005, and that time, what the idea was, there are so many amazing teachers in the world who need to connect to people in India. So we started inviting people, and this was a platform for the trainers, the facilitators, and the teachers. Now over these years, we have seen, we have in fact trained thousands of people in spirituality, healing modalities, and various such things. Now wellness is something which is different from so-called healthcare. Wellness is basically opposite of disease management. So today we are going to talk about this subject the whole day. So I'm really excited. This is the first conference that we're doing.
Now I'm going to welcome our first speaker of the day. His name is Arut Siva. He's been living in Singapore for the past 18 years and is a native of Coimbatore, Tamil Nadu. He spent actually 14 years and 5 million rupees to research of natural healing therapies. He runs 3 companies in Singapore, has a cutting edge diagnostic and therapeutic center in Singapore, and soon opening up one in Malaysia. So we'll welcome Arut Siva now, everyone.
Well, I'm really glad to be here. When Sandeep invited me a couple of weeks ago, I really didn't, I mean, this is my first invitation to India, though it's my home country, but it's become a foreign country to me because I changed citizenship. So I heard about Sandeep from our principal medi-consult, Wolfgang, when he came to Singapore, so I was longing to see him. And probably the day I called him, he said, "We are having a conference, why don't you come?" And I thought this is the best opportunity to see him, and here I am. So how my journey started into this was, I used to work in one of the biggest and the oldest hospital in Singapore. It's a 190 plus years old hospital, and I have been from IVF labs all the way to mortuary. And moreover, when a person dies in any ward on any bed, I get a message. Which ward, who's the person, what's the gender, because I need to activate a team from the eye center to go and talk to the relatives for cornea transplant. At that time Singapore was running very low and you need to harvest it within 4 hours. So because of working there for nearly 3.5 years, I had access to almost every part of the hospital, and I realized there's something drastically wrong in the medical system. Because when I look at our body and the way it is designed, we are designed with all redundancies, self-healing mechanism. But why is it that people are dying so young, so early, and so miserably? Honestly, it's a very miserable place to be in. If you've been to any hospital, you can see. Then I used to visit my friends in Malaysia who run naturopathy clinics. There I see people full of joy and energy, whereas in hospital, it's such a depressing environment. And then sometimes, you know, patients get so mad they even beat up the doctors and nurses, so they have to set up a team to protect them. But what's the problem? The thing is, what we all do is, we try to point fingers at others that they are not taking care of us. But to me, when you point like this, 3 fingers are pointing to you. To me, I always ask, what did you do? What did you take care of yourself? I always tell my clients, never outsource 2 things in life. Guess what it is? You should never outsource 2 things in your life. Guess, I give you 20 seconds. Suffering you can outsource if someone can take it. Basically, it's your health and wealth. Because these two truly belongs to you. And when it belongs to you is as long as this body and soul is together, all other things around you belongs to you. Else it belongs to someone else. All your wealth belongs to your kids if you die, and if they fight, they belong to the lawyers, and if you're sick, it belongs to the doctors and hospitals. So when it belongs to you is when you really take care of your health, your wealth belongs to you. Then I thought, okay, if that being the case, now I went to find out what's really causing problems in our life. Then when I analyze, actually the principles is very simple. We actually gave up all our foundations and basics, and we went for more and more luxury and comforts. And because of that, actually our body is breaking down. If you look at olden days, people were quite healthy. Why? No modern gadgets, no mixie, no grinder, nothing. Everything is to made from scratch. But now, you look, everything we are automated, and because of that, our size has ballooned. Why? We hardly move. We sit from morning to evening. And we don't go out in sun. Just because we don't go out in sun alone, we get at least a couple of hundred diseases. Why? Vitamin D is very, very important for us. And when I look at breast cancer cases, there are three common denominators, quite common. One is low levels of melatonin. Vitamin D3 is one of them. Why? Because they don't go out in sun. In a developed country, people always, from morning, they wake up early and get into the office before sun comes out. And by the time they leave office, it's already sunset. And day in and day out, it continues like this. Of course, our body is deficient in a lot of things. And secondly, the main problem in today's health is a couple of things. First, we lost touch with farmers. We think farming is not important. So because of that, what happens is some multinational monsters actually took over the control of seeds. So people like Vandana Shiva, Namalwar from India are fighting that seeds shouldn't be controlled by corporates. It should be with the families. And secondly, when both people started to work, especially the husband and wife, that's where another major problem started, because we tend to eat outside. So when in Singapore, like 95% of the people out all three meals a day, because both people have to work due to economic circumstances. So when you go out, actually, to talk about this topic, I need two full days, because of so much of foundations we have really missed out. So because of all this, and then a lack of organic farming, no? A lot of companies use heavily pesticide fertilizers, all artificial and synthetic, which our body cannot assimilate. So the basic things for life, which is air, water and food, all these three is now 90% polluted and corrupted. So because of that, our bodies are corrupted too. Not only corruption prevails everywhere in companies, it also prevails in our bodies, just because we don't take enough good care of it. And just look at the amount of induction cookers we have here. In olden days, people used stone fire, in firewood, then become gas, and now this is a modern day gadget. A woman standing in front of it and cooking all day, it's guaranteed she cannot make babies. Similarly, for the male, he will lose his fertility. The amount of magnetic field coming out of each cooker is super high. I'm not sure whether the knowledge of EMI, electromagnetic radiation and field is prevalent here, but in countries like Singapore, because we all live in apartments, 20-story, 30-story, even up to 50-stories now, we are in a cocoon of electromagnetic radiations. This impairs our cell from functioning normally. So already air, water, food is polluted. Now the environment itself is polluted. Because of all these factors, our body have totally lost its self-healing capabilities. Like recently I read about a man who is 127 years old in Peru. He lives close to nature. Until 127, he works in his field. He grows his own food. He only ate wild grown mushrooms and the seed grains, especially from his own farm. He can live up to 127. Humans are designed up to live up to 120. But now you look, my youngest client is a 3-week-old baby leukemia. So where did the problem start? The problem didn't start with the kid, it started with the parents. India and China will become the cancer capital of the world. Why? Why is it happening? And honestly, I've been to 28 countries. When I look at every country food, to me, I still believe Indian food is one of the best foods if prepared correctly, because we have protein, we have vegetables grown on top of the soil, below the soil, from leaves, stem, barks. I mean, we combine everything to form a nice meal, from sambar to rasam to puriyal to yogurt to sweet. I mean, all the six tastes are in this meal. Why all the six tastes are important is, if only we take all this, Our endocrine gland secretes certain enzymes and it can make use of this food to produce all the things it wanted. Like bone needs a different nutrition, our skin needs a different nutrition, our eye needs a different nutrition. But all this, our body has an innate wisdom to take what all it wants, but provided the food is right. But sadly, when I saw today's paper, I think we have lost our grounds on so many things. And I believe it's best we go back to nature and then we start building our bodies step by step. And to be healthy, it's really quite cheap. It's not that it's very expensive. It's very cheap provided we know what we are doing. Thank you, Sandeep, for reducing the electromagnetic radiation. So anyway, we have a lot of speakers lined up. I won't take up much time. So if you want, we can always chat here. I'll be here until tomorrow night. Thank you very much for the opportunity.
And our next speaker is Nishant. To tell you a little about Nishant, Nishant is an IT engineer by qualification, but an energy medicine scientist by choice. He has worked for MNCs like Hewlett Packard and Fortis Healthcare, etc. He has been in the wellness industry for over a decade now and has been doing research work on the human aura and its effects on our lives. Recently, he has created a modality called auric healing, which integrates the scientific and spiritual aspects of our aura and way to bring it into a vibrant state. So we'll welcome Nishant. Everyone. A little more energy required from everyone.
Thank you. So I welcome you all to the Energy Medicine Conference. I'd like to start up with a question that, you know, how many of you present here have had an experience like this? You walk into a room and you get a sense of, you know, energy there, probably something negative or something positive in that room. Pretty much everyone, right?
Yes.
Like you're meeting the person for the first time and you get a sense of whether the person is, you know, either you get attracted to a person or repelled by the person, right? It's in a way that you subconsciously or, you know, unknowingly are reacting to some energy, right? So this is what I feel the basics of energy medicine is all about, right? And this is what I'm gonna be speaking about, that what is this energy, how to know it on a very scientific basis, what is the scientific basis of this energy, and how it is really impacting our life. So this is, we have a company called Biofield Global Research Inc. And we are basically doing research work in terms of energy healing modalities and energy healing gadgets, just to show that how is this invisible energy affecting our lives and shaping our lives actually, right? So this is just brief about the company, that Biofield Global Research Inc. is involved in research of the human aura or the biofield energy and marketing of all types of biofield energy enhancing products, devices and processes. So our aim is to enhance and optimize the energetic potential of an individual to promote holistic wellness, because in fact, after I finish my presentation, you'll get to know that really it's the energy shaping our lives, not our physical efforts, just the physical efforts. It's basically the energy which is creating our lives, governing our lives, running our lives. And if you can control the root aspect of everything that is working, right, that's energy, you can achieve vibrant states of health, wellness, peace, everything that you can imagine, because after all, everything is energy. The vision is to spread the knowledge that we are energetic beings and not chemical beings, treating health in a holistic level. And that is what I feel energy medicine is all about, you know, because energy medicine treats the body as a whole. We're not saying that you have a physical body and that's it. We are taking to the possibility that, you know, there's much more beyond your physical level of existence. You have mental states, your emotional states, spiritual states. That is what energy medicine is all about. So our mission is to promote energetic wellness in the form of educating individuals on the use of energy medicine devices, because till the time you're not educating people, there's no use doing anything. If I'm not empowering people that this is what it is, people hardly know about energy medicine. Yes, these days it's picking up. We feel that it's the future of medicine, because even now modern medicine has started to think about it. You know, I think that probably something is wrong. Not wrong, probably something is not going the right way. So probably there is something more to medicines, you know. So that's why people, different hospitals now are open to the idea of energy medicine. They are like promoting the stuff. So scientifically research and validate energy healing modalities and products. What is energy medicine? The first and foremost question that whenever you talk about energy medicine, people hardly think, do you really have to take energy as medicine? You know, like people generally associate medicine as something only that you have to take, right? But you have to realize that in this, we are treating the future, it's the future of medicine, because it takes into account various factors to treat an individual other than just the physical body and diseases. It views the human body as an energetic system and not as chemical system, right? In chemical system, we say that if you have a problem, that is a symptom actually, you know. Like for example, you have a gastric pain, right? Sometimes the pain is here, sometimes the pain is here. And you start treating the symptom that you have. If pain is there, you have a Disprin. It'll go, it'll be healed. But actually what is happening, that is just a symptom. The root is here in your stomach. So in energetic medicine, we address, we try to find out with what is the root cause actually of the problem. And we take into account various factors, not just physical, emotional, spiritual, mental, everything is affecting your body and health. Energy medicine addresses the root cause of the problem and not just the symptom of the disease using sophisticated energy-based healing systems, mind-body healing techniques, reducing stress while taking care of nutrition. In fact, I think most of the doctors would agree, and in fact they say this statement over and over again. Some of the doctors would say that, you know, energy medicine doesn't exist, it's just a, you know, pseudo concept, etc. But the person, if he's not well, he's like, don't take stress. Unknowingly, they're saying, it's they're negating their own statement. Because energy medicine says there's much more beyond than the physical body. That means stress is also an important factor which aggravates the physical health, the disease health, right? So if you're taking stress, obviously the symptoms might go up, the BP might shoot up, the heart, the pulse rate might go up, right? So in energy medicine, we say that understanding the true health is on a holistic level, taking into account physical, mental, emotional and spiritual. So if a person, we generally say that if a person is healthy at all the levels, he's physically in a very healthy state, mentally sound, emotionally is calm and peaceful, spiritually he's doing everything that a person of, you know, good ethics should be doing at a spiritual level. So with that, we term that person as a healthy person. And not just that physical states are good, but the mentally the person is feeling depressed. That is not health, right? Now, generally, people have this concept, like, you know, we view things as duality. For example, most people believe that the universe is made up of two kinds of stuff. So now earlier I just told you that this is the basics of energy medicine. Now we're going, what is energy? I'm going to define you, help you identify what is energy. So people believe that the universe is made up of two kinds of stuff. First is matter, that's the body that you can see. For example, this pencil is matter. Then there are other people who say that everything is energy, you know. Mind, body, spirit, soul, vital force, life force, chi, everything is energy. And matter is just a manifestation of energy. In a few slides from now, we're going to see actually what was the scientific perception of matter and energy and how basically the interchangeability happened. So the second part says electromagnetic bioenergetic field. We all have some kind of energy field around us, which is basically like our blueprint of health, right? If I say that, you know, you have a physical problem, it is just not because there is something wrong in the physical body. As an energetic medicine point of view, we believe that there is something wrong with the blueprint of energy, you know. So there's something wrong with the electromagnetic field which is surrounding you. That is wrong. That is why the effect is reflected in the physical body and not vice versa. Right, next please. So these are the few assumptions of energy medicine. We say that living things possess a special cosmic energy field, which I choose to call it bioenergetic field or biofield. It's also known in different cultures as ki, chi, prana, life force, mana, etc. So pure energy is a biophysical substance separate from matter and indeed supersedes matter. That means there's some energy which supersedes matter. Electromagnetic fields are examples of pure energy and are identified with bioenergetic field. So our energy field that we talk about fall into the range of electromagnetic spectrum. So that's why we say it's, for simplicity we use the term that's electromagnetic field. Now if most people might be hearing about all this quantum physics, etc., it has finally proven that energy is everything. But the real part is quantum physics has not really been proven. It's still in the process of getting proved, right? Yes, there are concepts, but which somehow relate to our old metaphysical stuff that we practice, that we say that there's some kind of energy which is around you. At the molecular or subatomic level, it's just energy which creates everything in the universe. Doesn't really matter if it's a pencil, my body, or what, glass of water. Everything is elementary, everything is same. Quantum physics shows that the universe is one interconnected whole of which human consciousness is a part, that allowing that thus allowing the mind to control reality. So this also means that by the power of your thought and intention, you can actually have a physical effect on the universe around you. In fact, there's a whole theory that, you know, if you read something about the scientific experiment called the observer's effect, they said that electrons, while they were being shot from a electron gun, they behaved as a particle. No one was noticing, you know, the electron gun was in a room and there was a slit in front of it. When the electrons were being fired, when nobody was noticing the experiment, the electrons were behaving as waves. That means they were everywhere. But when the scientists started observing that experiment, the electrons reacted differently. They started behaving as a particle. So that was called the dual nature of electrons. That means an electron, which is the, you can say, elementary particle of the creation universe, can behave as a particle and as well as a wave, right? So that means the energy, it's a basically pack of electrons packed together in form of particles. The energy which is here, the electrons are behaving like wave. That's why you cannot see them, but they still exist. And manifestation, when you talk about you create your own reality and you talk about manifestation, that in fact, in our own metaphysical stuff, there have been cases in which our spiritual saints have really literally materialized things out of the thin air. How it happens? Because just by the power of their observation, a single pointed connectedness, they were able to materialize, you know, change the nature of the electron, the nature of electron, the wave nature of electron into a particle nature. And that's how materialization happened. This effect was called the observer's effect. You know, if you're observing something, you're creating a reality. Depending on the thoughts and observations, thoughts and emotions that are connected to that, right? So every time you're thinking something, you actually are creating a reality on a very scientific fundamental. It's just not a pseudo concept or a spiritual concept or a philosophy. It's actually science. Let's go to the next. So the bioenergetic medicine is the principles of energy medicine originate in quantum physics. It is a study of human and animal bodies as dynamic electromagnetic fields existing in an electromagnetic environment. That means I have electromagnetic field, the energy around me is electromagnetic, and that person sitting there also has electromagnetic field. So in a way, we are floating in a sea of electromagnetic energy. We are connected. Physically, we might be at a distance, we might be separated, but at an energetic level, it's all connected. One body is connected to the second by a sea of electromagnetic energy, right? It's based on Einstein's theories of quantum physics. These energetic concepts are being integrated into medicine for a comprehensive approach to disease diagnosis, prevention, and treatment. So this is basically quoted from a book about this author, Joan. So now the modern science and mainstream medical doctors are now open to the possibility of probably, you know, experimenting if there's more to medicine, if we can probably combine the whole the age-old concepts of medicine, traditional medicine, etc., with the modern discoveries in energy medicine or electromagnetics, right? Next. So energy fields are the energy fields of life, actually. It's controlling your life, it's governing your life. We feel that, you know, if you're physically healthy, that's it. And also that, you know, it's the strength or the health of electromagnetic fields actually define how healthy you will be eventually. If the electromagnetic field, in fact, electromagnetic field is also known as the aura of a person, you know. Layman calls it the vibrations or the vibes of a person, like, you know, You meet for the person for the first time, you say, oh, I didn't really like the vibes of a person, you know. Subconsciously, everybody is reading aura, everybody is reacting to some kind of energy, which is, on a scientific level, we call it biofield, bioelectromagnetic field, electromagnetic field, bioenergetic field. It's all the same. A spiritual or a new age healer might call it as aura. The layman terms the same thing as vibes or vibrations around a person. So energy fields are postulated to constitute the fundamental unit of the living and non-living. The atomic level or the energetic level, there's no difference between a living thing and a non-living thing. Everything has an electromagnetic field. But yes, again, it depends. Like for a living thing, we say that aura or the electromagnetic field are also impacted by the thoughts and emotions. So if the person is thinking something, the electromagnetic fields would keep on changing. It's dynamic, you know, it keeps on changing. Whereas static energy, like, you know, a pencil or a podium or a mic, will not really have that much energy shift. It has an electromagnetic field, but the shift is not there, right? It's a static energy. Till the time a human consciousness interacts with that system, and, you know, that's how exchange happens. That's how the dynamization process works. And so it's not energy, it's static, you know, it's consciously vibrating. Vibration produces electromagnetic field. It says energy and matter were separate in distinct substances. So energy is something that you cannot see, and matter is this thing which you can see, physically touch and feel. So this was the prior assumption. And they say, although appearing continuous to the naked eye, matter was composed of discrete localized atoms. So this was a theory. But with the advent of new age, you know, techniques and the discoveries in modern physics, the whole shift happened, and that's the whole theory changed. Let's go to the modern physics now. So current picture says energy and matter are really the same stuff, you know, it's interchangeable. Einstein proved it with the equation E is equal to mc squared. That's matter and energy are interconvertible, you know. You can create matter from energy and also energy from matter. It's vice versa, it's connected. The discrete nature of matter is confirmed, energy is also discrete, you know. So this is how the matter is, for example, we take the example of this pencil. Pencil being the matter that you can see, particles. Then you go down, it's molecules. Molecules are a group of atoms together. Then it's atoms. If you further go down, it's nuclei and electrons. If you further go down, it's protons and neutrons. If you further go down, they're quarks. And if you further go down, there's energy. It's nothing there. You know, virtually it's more like empty space. Energy comes from somewhere, energy goes out somewhere into the universe and disappears. It appears. So, in fact, there's a whole, I think in Hinduism we have this concept that, you know, we come from nothing, we go back into nothing. So everything is Maya, everything is an illusion. At the energetic level, yes, it's true. So this scientific experiment actually proved that, you know, when you talk about the illusionary world, the Maya, the, you know, concepts of Maya and illusion, that everything is just an illusion, if it's not really there. You know, you might perceive it to be there, but it's not really there. So this is actually proven by the science when it says if you keep on expanding stuff, at the elementary level it's nothing, it's empty space. At the surface level it might appear to be something, but it's not really there, right? So yes, everything is illusion. You have a question? Quark is basically like the subatomic particles, you can say. It's like a, like we have strings, we have super strings, then you have quarks. So like the very, very particle, you can say. It's a name given to the type of energy. So now we come to the concept of what is the biofield or what is an aura. So the concept of aura basically means that, you know, the human body, why aura exists? The human body consists of trillions of cells which produce minute electrical impulses. So electrons and protons, and these are charged particles. When they vibrate, they produce an electrical impulse. So these electrical charges in turn develop some kind of magnetic force field around them. There's a law in the physics. They say that wherever there's electrical energy flowing, the magnetic field is it's produced around that. You know, for example, you have a screwdriver, you work with electrical appliances, it gets a, you know, magnetization. It gets magnetized. It is able to attract small iron filings, you know. It was just a good conductor of electricity. It was magnetized. So that's why I say ki these electrical charges in turn develop some kind of magnetic force field around them, which the scientists call the electromagnetic field or the biofield. So that means all your cells are working, are producing some amount of electromagnetic fields, and overall they're constituting your or entire energy field, right? So what is the importance of this field? So our human body is actually just energy densely packed together. So again, the same thing that I told you, that you know, energy field appears to be the basis of everything. It's the blueprint which creates everything. So we have a physical body, we have the mental, emotional, spiritual and astral body. In terms of energy medicine, we say that you have an energy body which creates the physical body. So if you have a disease here, the problem is here at the energetic level, you know. And if you'd want to treat a disease, address the root cause, not the symptom. Symptom is appearing in the physical body. And we keep on giving medicines, chemicals, injections, etc. Sometimes they work, sometimes they doesn't. You know, it doesn't work. Sometimes the doctor says we have given our best and the body is not accepting it. If it's a protocol based system, that means you have a problem, do this, the body will have to accept if you're treating body as a machine, you know. But sometimes it happens, the body simply rejects an organ donation, you know, organ implant implant when it's given. So that means there's some kind of life force, some kind of energy which is really, really, really shaping up or really, really controlling how the body functions. And every doctor would agree that, you know, that medicines, etc., they just trigger the body's, you know, innate natural healing mechanism, right? They don't heal the body. So the field is what keeps us intact and gives us an illusion of matter. So it's some kind of electromagnetic field which is around us, which is like the information, which is the field which is storing our atoms together. It's like a shield, you can say, which is packing all the atoms together and keeps us whole and intact. Even our cells communicate with each other in form of weak electromagnetic impulses. Example, neurons in the brain firing electrical responses to trigger chemical response. So the moment you think something, there's a different part of the brain which gets activated. A different set of neurons are being fired. Electrical impulses are conveyed to the, you know, particular organs. For example, if I want to move my muscle, my left hand, I thought about it, the brain gave the appropriate signals to the muscles, etc., and that's how I'm able to move. So neurons in the brain also fire electrical responses to trigger chemical responses and muscle movements. Next. So we say that disruption in the body occurs when there is a disruption in our electromagnetic information system. Why I call it information system? Because it's like, you know, you have all the 70 trillion cells in your body. Have the capacity to become any organ of your body, you know. So the cell, basically you can say it's the information to become a heart, a part of the heart, and information to become a part of the brain is stored in a very tiny, tiny cell. All the information, all the programs, I call it programs, it's stored in the body, it's stored in the cells. So that means it's some kind of information is produced in the body, which is stored in the body. For example, someone met with an accident 10 years back, you know, and as for science, I do not really know the exact number of years it takes for the whole cells to replace, but it's less than 10, you know, approximately 7 or 8 years. So the whole body, every cell in the body is replaced. But yes, all the cells are replaced now, and the accident was 10 years back, still the person feels that trauma, that pain is still there, right? Because there was information system of pain, information of pain was registered in the cells. And that's how, even though the new cells were there, the information was passed on, you know, of suffering, of trauma, of pain in that localized area. That's how they say that our body is actually information system. It's electromagnetic information system. Example, there's a disruption in the body's electromagnetic field. For example, Parkinson's disease, there's uncontrollable movement of our hands and body, etc., shaking, etc. We cannot control it because a different chemical response is firing now. The body is not able to, what do you call, project a right information in form of electrical impulses. So the field is always exchanging information in form of energy with our environment. For example, you know, right now, if you're all sitting here, we all have electromagnetic fields. Generally, it has been observed that electromagnetic field of an average human being ranges from about 4 to 5 feet in radius. It's all around you. So right now, if you're all sitting together, you're actually contributing and impacting each other's energy field. You're all a part of one energy field right now, right? And for example, why at certain places we feel good, whereas at certain places we feel negative? Because our electromagnetic field is exchanging information with our environment. If the environment is positive, we exchange information and we feel good. If the environment is negative, we exchange information and we feel bad about it. You know, just repel from that place. So these are the characteristics of bioenergy field or the aura. This field is governed by the information flowing in and out of our electromagnetic system. For example, a stressful situation, like a sudden shock or something, causes physiological changes in the body. For example, in states of extreme grief, the person is not able to express himself or herself. If they feel choked, you know, they're not able to do because a stressful situation. There was an information exchange that some news came as a shock. That was an exchange happened. The brain fired a chemical response, electrical response, the chemical response were done. So that resulted into a physiological change in the body, right? So continuously we're exchanging information, our body's processing. We might be thinking that right now, you know, I'm not thinking nothing. But at the subconscious level, as the psychologists say, that at the subconscious level, we're always exchanging information. Our subconscious mind is always recording it, always processing some form of other, you know, exchanging information. In fact, even if I ask you, for example, you meet the person for the first time, you get a feeling about the person, that what is the overall personality of the person, you know, because that energy has a information, that energy is basically information in your electromagnetic field. You come and interact with your electromagnetic field with that person, you exchange information. And it happens that you get a sense, you know, this person is negative, this person is very pessimist, or this person is so and so. It's a mutual thing. Everybody does that. It's very common. So essentially we can say energy medicine is actually information medicine. If you want to correct any imbalance of the mind-body, just give the right information to the electromagnetic system of the body and it will set the overall energetic system. For example, we talk about New Age healing modalities like Reiki. And could be crystals healing, could be any form of meditative work. What we are asked to believe that, you know, while doing healing, intend for something to happen. Or if you're doing some healing for someone else, you're giving that person energy, you're focusing. The observer's effect comes into action. The electrons, they were behaving like a disease pattern. Now because of your observation, because of your focus intention, the same electrons will start behaving like a health pattern. They'll start getting converted into a healthy pattern. And then you are asked to give an intent, you know, focus, give an intent. So that means we are basically giving the right information to the body. The body knows what to do, how to do, you know, and how much to do. At the physical level, we might think that, you know, okay, we might be overdoing energy. But in energy medicine, I think this is a little safer than this thing, all allopathic medicines, that in energy medicine, if we are giving extra amount of energy, if the cells have absorbed the energy, they will not accept it anymore, you know. So to correct any energetic imbalance, give the right information and the whole thing will set right. Next, please. The question is, how does it impact our health? So some people might be thinking that yes, we agree that, you know, there's electromagnetic field. So what do we do about that? How is it really impacting my health? But the truth is, the strength of the aura or the biofield depends on the health of the cells. If the field is stronger, that means our cells are producing enough electrical impulses, energy to communicate with each other. That means there is a stronger magnetic field. So if it's electromagnetic field of 10 units, for example, hypothetical situation, 10 units of magnetic energy would be generated. That means overall the energy of the aura is equivalent to the electrical and magnetic field produced by the body. So the stronger the energy it is, you know, that means the cells are producing really good information, cells are producing really good high voltage. So the stronger would be your aura. That means stronger would be your health. Physical, mental, emotional, spiritual, all at the holistic level. You'll be healthy. So whereas if the field diminishes due to any reason or our immune system gets weak and we end up developing stress, which is the cause of various diseases. So first, everything happens at the energetic level. You know, in terms of like I've been researching in the field of aura and energy medicine for the past 10 years. And I used to, I had actually heard the concept that, you know, whatever happens, whatever has to happen in the physical body first comes in aura at the energetic level. Then it takes about 3 to 6 months, depending on the level of the strength of your aura. It depends from there, how much time will it take for you, for that energetic imbalance to manifest itself as a physical disease. But I've been using the systems of energy medicine and aura. I use a system called RFI, Resonant Field Imaging. It's an aura imaging device, and with which I was able to detect tumors, cancers, and minor areas of pain, etc., up to 3 to 6 months in advance before they actually manifested in the physical body. At that moment, the client said that, you know, it is really not there. So I don't know if it's really going to be true or not. But after 5 months, I have had cases where clients are calling me up with the ultrasound medical reports, MRI reports, that this is here, the exact position which you told me, you know. But now what do we do about it? To which the answer is, at the energetic level, it's very easy for you to probably remove this energy, because it's still energy. Energy is able to, you know, we can release that energy there and then. But if it appears in the physical body, that means now there's a denser layer now. The energy has become more densed. It takes longer to heal. Yes, everything can be set right by energy medicine, the principles of energy medicine, followed correctly with the right nutrition, with the right guidance, etc., health. But, you know, it takes time if it's something manifests in the physical body.
Now that we often hear these days about the power of positive thinking, usually this focuses on what it can do for the individual around us. Arut Siva looks at the science behind the claims.
Can you directly influence the world around you, which is the power of your mind? Although it might sound far-fetched, a leading Russian scientist believes we can do exactly that. And using a device that photographs human energy field.
In fact, this scientist is a leading energy medicine researcher. He's been researching on the field of bioenergetics, aura energy medicine. His name is Professor Konstantin Korotkov. He's a Russian scientist.
With our emotions, with our intentions, we can directly influence our environment, our space.
The scientist who's been researching on the field of aura and energy medicine, how a consciousness can really impact the world around and also our bodies. In fact, there's another experiment. I think it's really common, you know, to hear about that water experiment, Dr. Masaru Emoto of Japan. He basically conducted a research that, you know, when an intention is focused on a water, you know, some water sample, he took a water glass of water sample, and he intended thoughts of hatred, that I hate you, I want to kill you, etc. Then he froze that water, took one of the crystals, saw it, you know, magnified under an electron microscope, and what he discovered, the water crystal, he did a couple of experiments, in the control condition, the water, which was not targeted with any intention, just plain water crystal, it was more like a distorted crystal. Yes, but it still was good, looking good. Whereas in the case of the water sample, which was projected by the emotions or thoughts of hatred, the whole crystal, which was in the first picture visible, that distorted. It was like more like a, you know, creepy face. The structure, the cluster, the crystal changed into a creepy face. And then the third round of experiment was projecting positive intentions, loving intentions to the water. I love you, I heal, you know, I want to heal you. Thank you for healing me. All the goodness, all the kind thoughts. And again, the same experiment. And now what he noticed is that the structure of the water formed, you know, diamond-shaped crystals. And this experiment was repeated over and over again by playing different musics, projecting different intentions just by writing down intention on the water sample, repeating the same experiments again. And every time, and not just at the physical location, physical vicinity, the experiments were also conducted in a different city altogether. There was a lake in different city, and the people were praying from a different city and projecting their intentions onto that lake. You know, the same set of experiments were repeated, and they were able to quantify data that, you know, given even before and after prayer, there was a measurable difference in the structure of the water crystals. So this proves actually that we are all connected by electromagnetic field, which is called the aura, energy field, whatever you want to call it. But the truth is, we are connected, and we have a definite impact on our bodies, on our surroundings, and everything, right? So the connection between electromagnetic field and bodies, simply put, they are invisible lines of force that emanates strongly from, now we're talking in terms of first part which we covered, it's for more in terms of the physical body generating energy, electromagnetic fields, and how it's basically governing your health. Now we are coming to a part in which we will talk about a little on the electromagnetic field radiation as Siva talked about, which is emanating from all these electrical appliances and how it's really impacting your health. That's a counter in which we can see the intensity, the visual and the audible way of how electromagnetic fields affecting, you know, are affecting our lives. So this is a counter which has a number, and this basically tells you the intensity. For example, if I start, you know, probably, yeah, just give me mobile or laptop. For example, I think laptop will also do. Look at the, it's screaming, right? So now, because the intensity produced by a laptop is far more greater than what my body can absorb. And this is how your body actually cries out, you know, when in a field of electromagnetic stress. This creates energy field which is stressing your body, which is not good. And this is the reason for most of the stress or problems that we have, you know. We're having the best of diet, we think that we're having the best diet, and we think that we are in a good shape, but still we get symptoms like, you know, fatigue and, you know, dizziness, sleep disorders, you know, mood swings, etc. So arthritis, etc. Well, all this is like a common symptom now. Stomach problems, gastrointestinal problems. So that is actually also an effect of these electromagnetic fields. You know, there are like two types of electromagnetic fields. One is called the low frequency electromagnetic fields, which are emitted by electricity in home appliances, the common things, like bulbs, fans, even if you're driving a vehicle. In fact, that day I just noticed this happened to be in my car, and I kept my laptop bag over it, and suddenly the button got pressed. And the moment I started the engine, it started screaming, ching, ching. It's like, okay, I didn't really notice, you know, till now, I haven't noticed that, you know, while I'm driving the car, I'm still in the negative electromagnetic field spectrum, you know. My body is still getting stressed, even while driving, right? So the second type of electromagnetic field is high frequency electromagnetic field emitted by wireless devices such as cell phones, cordless laptops, Wi-Fi, from our cell towers and high power lines. These days we cannot really live without a cell phone. It's like our everyday, help. We really need that to function properly. But yes, probably it's impacting our health. There have been case studies which have shown that, you know, the radiations which are emitted by the cell phones seems to be the cause of the brain tumors and cancers in adults and children as well, you know. And in fact, you might be thinking that, you know, you should have okay. So the low frequency electromagnetic fields doesn't sound so dangerous, you know. You might be thinking like, you know, low hair, though, it won't really affect. But actually, it's a wrong statement. Some people might enjoy great health while they eat all the junk food or stay on their cell phones all day long. So it might be that they are genetically blessed, but some people are not. Most of us. The common symptoms which are the effects of electromagnetic fields include unexplained headaches, no cause, but still it's there, fatigue, digestive problems, sleeping disorders, etc. So it's not obviously because of EMF, we cannot really blame that, because right now if you look at the fruits and vegetables that we eat, they're also full of pesticides. The air is polluted, the water is poison probably, and the water is not healthy, and because of fluoride, etc., all the chemicals added to the water, and increasingly with pesticides, which also impact our health, because whatever we ingest, it's really going to impact our body. It's again a scientific fact. In Ayurveda, they say jasa anvesaman, so obviously you're going to be impacted. An increase in EMF exposure with the advent of TV and computers and the increase in the number of appliances we use has certainly played its part as well. So our health is just not affected by the food we eat or the environment we live in. But right now, as we're using our mobile phones, we're continuously exposing ourselves with that harmful radiation, harmful electromagnetic fields, 24/7. Because some people also have the habit of sleeping with their cell phones tucked under the pillow as an alarm, you know. But what you are not realizing that while you're sleeping, you know, you're still letting your brain absorb that radiation, and it will give you symptom, if not now, probably in 10 years. But it is going to give you some kind of disease, some kind of problems, right? In fact, the last, even I had this habit of, you know, setting up alarm on my mobile phone and just tucking it under my pillow. But in the last conference, Wolfgang, when he told us, you know, okay, this is how he showed with this Micmac, and this, that the bell rang. It's like, okay, now I actually put it on flight mode when I'm sleeping. So my phone is effectively switched off from 10 p.m. till about 8 a.m. the next morning. So even though I'm using it as alarm, but still in the flight mode. So there's relatively no electromagnetic field. I would not say no, but as a low electromagnetic field. So let's go to the next part. So what do the EMFs do to our body? It's important to understand that these EMFs we are talking about here are more technically man-made, because as we said earlier, that our bodies are also producing electromagnetic fields, you know. But the frequency of these fields are much, much, much lower than as compared to the man-made radiations, right? For example, Earth also has an electromagnetic field around it. There's a, if you say that, imagine this is the Earth, and there's a layer of energy which is called the ionosphere around it, which is like a protective atmosphere around the Earth. Between the Earth and the ionosphere, there's a frequency, there's a extremely low electromagnetic field, ELF, you know, as I say ELF, extremely low electromagnetic field frequency. The frequency of that zone is about 7.83 hertz. That is also called the Schumann resonance. So our bodies are actually designed to tune into that rhythm of that, approximately that same frequency. That means we can ideally absorb that much frequency, that's 7.83 hertz, in a second. That's frequency is basically just a measure of how many times a particle is vibrating in 1 second. For example, if I vibrate this pen for like 3 times in a second, this is the frequency is 3 times. So our body is not designed to probably accept the radiation which is caused by the man-made electromagnetic fields, because the body has its own natural electromagnetic field, and this is the man-made. When they come into our in contact with into our electromagnetic field, our body gets all out of sync when man-made frequencies enter our body from outside the body. Our bodies are born on this earth with a beautiful and natural resonance to the earth's electromagnetic field. So that is very evident when you go into a mountain, you know, probably hilly region, or you know, at the mountain top, or in a forest, or nearby a waterfall. You feel so relaxed, you feel so peaceful, the body relaxes, the mind gets into a state of, you know, calmness, etc. You feel, you know, the energy pulsing you, you feel healthy, you feel more energetic, you know, you feel more refreshed, because there's an exchange of energies happening. You're in tune with the earth's natural frequency. Prior to this electrical things that happened with, you know, people who were living in villages, or probably not in apartments, etc., they were living in homes, they were still connected to earth's magnetic field. They were exchanging energies. Before the buildings began to be electrified in the early part of the 20th century, people's bodies were able to benefit from this resonance all the time. They were working in the farms, you know, working with earth energy, exchanging energy. But after this electric field we are living right now, if you're living in the apartment building, so obviously, yes, we are engulfed and encompassed into the electrical zone. And 24/7 we are bombarded by that information, by that negative harmful radiation. So obviously we cannot really help getting sick. So let's, the immune system and the EMF, our bodies create subliminal stress. Subliminal is basically even you will not be able to realize it that you are getting stressed. It's very, very, very fine states of stress, you can say, all the time in the presence of electromagnetic fields. With this you can check really, you know, whenever there's electromagnetic field, this is how your body's, you know, helping. So late Dr. W.R. Ede from Loma Linda University describes how our body's internal antenna picks up the stress and how our body responds in the following ways. The blood, this is how, in the presence of an electromagnetic field, this is how my body would react, or anybody would react. The flow of blood and oxygen diminishes in all except major organs like the brain and heart. Any systems including digestion and immunity that aren't necessary for fight or flight response are put on hold. So that really gives you a sign that why you have digestion problem all the time probably. Blood pressure and heart rate as well as blood sugar levels increase to prepare the body for danger. So it's like a fight and flight mechanism. The body starts storing the energy in form of fat to prepare it for danger. And there's a scientific study which says that EMF also knock the ions out of the cells and interfere with the metabolism within the cells. That means the phenomenon accounts for deficiencies in calcium for arthritis and leading to arthritis and anxiety, lithium for depression, schizophrenia, potassium for Alzheimer's disease. So these are the basically causes, you know, where the EMFs are knocking out these nutrients from the cells. So now the question is, how does high frequency, this radio towers, cell phones, etc., harm us? So all the effects that we talked about was done by the low electromagnetic fields. High electromagnetic fields do all the same stuff, but at a very, very, very faster rate. You know, if you're talking to a mobile phone, you know, I think the exact frequency, again, I don't know exactly, but I think about the mobile phone vibrates about 18 million times per second. And a body can absorb only 8 times, 7.83 hertz per second. So it's a million times more, you know, when the body can absorb, the extent, the energy can absorb. So they're even more hazardous. They do all the low frequency EMFs do, but even more, even faster. So this is what electromagnetic fields are, you know, this is how electromagnetic fields are impacting our life. Electromagnetic fields can actually heal the body and also bring the body out of shape, you know. It's because essentially we're electromagnetic beings, you know. Now you might be realizing that, you know, when you talk about energy, we're electromagnetic beings, we're exchanging information. And the human body is designed to transfer and receive information continuously. It's like we are exchanging information. So the question is, now when we know this, you know, we know that these are the facts of energy medicine. We are treating energy, which is the basis of everything. We're treating the body, we are viewing the body as at a holistic level. We're viewing the body as an electromagnetic field, right, which has an information system, right? So if you want to correct any imbalance, we need to correct the information system. So next, let's go. So how do we keep our biofield or aura healthy? The food for the cells is electromagnetic energy, right? So each cell has a particular frequency at which it must vibrate to remain healthy. When the cells drop their frequency of vibration, we get a disease due to the disruption in the energy field. One way is to provide the right nourishment to the cells by using PEMF therapy. So PEMF basically stands for pulsed electromagnetic field. It's a therapy based system in which we give you, there's a machine which gives the frequency which the body is designed to, you know, absorb. That is about the Schumann resonance, we say 7.83 hertz. You lie down on a mat, like the brain for example. Cells do not really know if it's really happening in the body or if it's just imagination. If you just, you know, close your eyes and imagine that you're walking on a beach or probably relaxing on a very sunny day at the beach or taking a walk in the forest, your body will start going into a state of deep relaxation because the brain doesn't really know if it's really happening or if it's just imagination. It fires the same chemical responses, triggers the same muscles, etc. Everything happens the same exactly. So now when you lie down on that mat, what it does is basically gives you that energy field. It creates the energy field around you, of which is the Earth's frequency actually, right? The body simply absorbs that energy and starts to go into that mode in which the whole healing happens. You know, in fact, the next speaker would be talking in detail about how this PMF therapy works. So sunlight also emits photons. You know, this is like, you know, we say that, you know, when in presence of sunlight, the plants make their own food. How? Energy in terms of light is called biophotons. It's when the sunlight is shining on something, it's actually imparting or giving certain packets of energy, which is called quanta, you know, quanta. Photons of energy, which is given to the plant, and plant uses that energy to create its own food. And vitamin D, as we talk about, when we absorb sunlight, the light is giving energy to our body, and our body is using those photons to create vitamin D in itself. So sunlight emits photons, packets of energy, which when absorbed directly helps the cells to function properly. It's a nourishment to the cells, just like recharging a battery. So negative ions also help to reduce stress and increase the productivity. For example, ever notice how fresh you feel when near a waterfall or a beach? Because these places are full of negative ions. So now, negative ions have a positive effect on our health, and positive ions have a negative effect on our health. So all these electrical devices generate a field of positive ions, which, you know, it creates stress, you know. And all these, what these are basically in the market, they're now available negative ionizers, you know, that's available in the markets, which can be installed in offices, homes, etc. They produce more of negative ions, so that, you know, negative, positive, after they're neutralized, if the excess of negative ions in the environment, you feel better, you feel recharged, right? Next slide. In fact, there is another device called Orgonite, which is basically a product designed by the research done by Dr. William Ray. Right? So he was basically, what he found, that there's some, like the same energy that we call it life force energy, ki, chi, prana, he called it organ energy, you know, like organ energy. He named it classically, there are two types of organ energy. One is DOR, that's deadly organ or negative energy. One is POR, that positive organ or positive energy. So he was actually making up devices which were accumulating, you know, some kind of, it's like a chamber stacked with organic and non-organic stuff, you know, put together in layers. So what he observed, that when he was stacking the organic, non-organic in a chamber sort of stuff, it started accumulating the organ, that's life force energy, inside the chamber. And he was, supposedly people were getting cured of cancer just by sitting in the box for about half an hour daily for 6 months. People were getting cured, you know. And then when the claims started spreading, the FDA came into action. They banned him, put him in jail, burned his laboratory, you know, etc. And he died of heart attack, you know. But there were some followers of this technology. They, after about 20 years, 30 years, they researched the whole thing again. They again revived this whole organite fundamental working of absorbing energy. There's another lady called Dawn and Paddlecroft somewhere, I think. What they did earlier, if you see the picture, it's the organ accumulator was 50% organic and 50% non-organic stuff put together. But it was more of an accumulator. Now, accumulator says if there's a positive charge into my environment, it will accumulate all positive energy. If there's a negative charge in my environment, the job of an accumulator is to accumulate. It will start accumulating all the negative energy. So we cannot really use an accumulator in this environment when we are all, you know, already surrounded by electromagnetic fields. So there was a couple who basically adds a quartz crystal into this organite. So what they did basically was, quartz has the property of piezoelectric effect. That means if this is quartz crystal, if I squeeze it, you know, if I squeeze it under pressure, when it's under pressure, the ends get polarized. They start producing electrical impulses. For example, you have a gas lighter. In that also a quartz crystal is used. When you strike it, it gets a pressure and there's electrical impulse which fires. That's how electricity is produced. You have quartz crystal in your transistors to tune into the right frequency. You have quartz crystal into your watches, you know. So quartz crystal, really this piezoelectric effect of quartz crystal is really prevalent in different stuff. So what they essentially did was, it's a liquid resin full of metals, different metals. Resin is organic, non-organic is metals. So metals absorb energy and organic repels energy. So this was a push-pull mechanism. So when they added a crystal inside that, so they started to notice that energy, the negative energy, is now being transmuted into positive energy, you know. And this was the new organite which came into production. In India, this technology is not available. And in fact, we are the only company who are, you know, researching on this subject more and more and providing this organites. But in countries like US, Europe, it's really, really good and really, really prevalent technology. People are using in agriculture, because it just transforms energy from negative state to positive state, you know. So you can use it in form of healing. You can use it in plants. You can use it in to negate the effects of electromagnetic fields. I'm not saying they absorb it, but it works in the principle like, you know, you have a cell phone jammer, you know, it creates a field around you, which starts to negate the negative effects of these electromagnetic fields. So this was organized in the news that this was the giant vegetables, you know. When an organite was tucked under a plant, this was the result. The average size was like this, and under the effect of organite, this all beetroots became this huge, you know. So this is miracles of the giant veggies. This was an article which was published in the newspaper. Secret energy pills push mother nature into high gear. So the production of plants, because in humans we might say that, you know, this is placebo, if, you know, it might be my thoughts working. But something like plants, you know, it's like a blind study. So using meditation also as a tool to reduce stress helps you to increase your aura. Using crystals, the new age tools, to help you increase the vibrancy of aura, because everything is electromagnetic, everything has a vibration energy. Using pure aromatic essential oils too helps in expanding this energy field. Performing rituals like white sage smudging, aura cleansing activities also helps you to shift your focus on our energy system, which in turn increases our energy because of the fact that whatever we focus on grows. So if we focus on energy, it will start to expand. So now we, I think the concepts are clear about energy medicine and the electromagnetic field, is it? Yeah. So now there's also a whole range of devices, which we say that they are aura imaging devices. So what is the aura scanning for, what is the use of aura scanning for a common man and its implication in the medical world? So when we now we have realized that everything is energy and it's interconvertible matter and energy are same thing actually. So this, if we get to know that, you know, if we take an aura scan of a person, if we get to know that this is what the status of his health is, not at just the physical level, but the energetic level as well. So if there's some negative energy or negative low frequency energy in the energetic level, so without fail, if the person does not really improve his health, this energy is going to come near, become more denser, more denser, more denser, till the time it comes physically, finally in the physical body as a disease, right? So in terms of medical health benefits, or it's more like a preventive, you know, energy scan. If you know that something is going to happen, if you become really active in trying to avoid that, you can really avoid that, right? So there's no point thinking that, you know, ki aura imaging is just there, it's just in the air. It really has scientific explanations. So when our aura gets contaminated with these energetic, so in fact that's the same thing, you know, that we view at the energetic medicine level, we said every disease, even a virus, is actually an energy. You know, it appears first as a form of energetic imbalance. Over a period of time, it might manifest itself in a physical disease. Usually we can say that we can detect imbalances up to 3 to 6 months in advance before they manifest as a disease. This is how aura looks like probably at the energetic level. The whole vibrant states are full of health, vitality, good information, good energy. A diminished aura is something like that. You know, it has low energy, low vibrancy, dull colors, etc. So this was the first aura imaging system, Simeon Kirlian. What he was basically trying to research, ki we know about the energy medicine, energy stuff, how can I really photograph it? And what he accidentally discovered, he was having a photographic plate. He kept his hand like this, and he was trying to, you know, plug a thing into a socket, switch in the socket. So he actually get a jolt of energy, you know, electricity. And what he noticed that, you know, after the everything was over, there was an imprint of his hand on the photographic plate, something like that. That's of a coin, but that in his case it was more of a hand. So this was an accidental discovery which led to the whole discovery of aura and Kirlian cameras, etc. So what the limitation of that system, whatever could be placed onto that small plate can be photographed. In fact, in the video that you saw, you have to keep your fingers, etc., taking electromagnetic imprint. So the next system came was PIP technology, which uses light as a source, basically. Now, earlier, if you remember, we discussed that, you know, when the cells are producing electrical impulses, when there's electrical spark, a light is produced, right? Common phenomenon. So that means 70 trillion cells are producing electrical impulses. That means that much light energy is also emitted, photons, you know, light sparks are produced. So that means you can say the spiritual, again, theory that we are light beings, we are beings of light, we are light workers, etc. It's again the same theory. Even science says that you are actually beings of light. Your body is producing light, right? So this works on the principle that every organ has a specified limit or state or bandwidth, you can say, of the light it should produce to remain healthy. If the light diminishes, right, the organ means the organ is getting stressed. If the light is over, that means the organ is exerting overpressure, extra effort to maintain itself. So now this uses that, you know, the person has to stand against a white background. There's a full spectrum bulb focused on the opposite of the person. Light is bombarded on the person, like a projector, for example, like this. So now the areas, for example, go to the next slide. For example, if you notice these pictures, these aura imaging pictures. If you look at the first stage on the left side, the back of the person, that's more of vibrant green energy. Why these colors appear? Because the cells are producing enough light. So when the external light comes in the body, it reflects the pattern. External light is reflected. And this reflection appears to be in form of green and yellow energy. Right? At some places, for example, if the person is having some back pain. That back pain, why back pain? Because the cells are not producing electrical energy. That means low light. So now when the external energy is bombarded, the part of the body which is producing low light, it will absorb that energy, and that's how it's reflected in this picture in form of a low pool of red energy in the lower back. That's how the system works to identify whether the organs are really working fine or not at the energetic level. But the limitation of the system is the person has to be in bare minimum clothes, you know, so almost naked, which is not really possible all the time. So then the third, this is basically I did a small research, the effect of an organite on water. First cases say that, you know, this is normal water jug without an organite. So ideally in this color, this technology, we look for the positive colors, which are green, yellow, white colors, right? There's a vibrant energy. After we kept an organite under the jug of water for about a minute or 2 minutes, the whole vibrancy shifted. If you look at the first and second picture, compare it, the whole white color has started coming. And after 2 hours, it was a static controlled thing. So nothing was being moved, you know, while the picture was shot. So laptop was there, the setup was there, nothing was moved. So after 2 hours, what happened is the whole energy shift happened. Now there was more of white, more of symmetrical patterns, if you see. Because in this system, we also look for the color distribution and the symmetrical, the quality and the quantity. So this was how this organite really shifted the energy of water. It didn't really purify the water. Some people say that, you know, I've had people buying organites from me and they say, "Okay, will it purify the water?" No, it doesn't. It's not a purifier. You know, it just basically shifts the energy. Your water would be the most purified water, but it might be dead water without no energy, right? So this basically increases the energy, increases the life force or the vibrancy of the energy in the water or any you know, any stuff. Okay, so this was the third imaging system which is called the RFI, resonant field imaging. That is the one that I'm currently using. It's basically based on the system of MRI and MRI technology. In MRI, we send a magnetic wave inside the body and see the alignment of cells and different organs on a photographic plate. In this theory, we said that our bodies are producing electromagnetic fields. So why do you really have to put something inside the body? You just take a handheld counter, it's an electromagnetic field counter, and check the frequency which is emitted by your body, right? So basically we divide the body into about 40 zones which cover your physical, psychological, chakra, health, etc. We keep on taking the frequencies with the help of a counter, and we keep on adding it, feeding into the software assigns it different colors and interpretation that what each color means. So every organ has a specified bandwidth of frequency with ideally it should vibrate at, right? This is how the report looks like. There's the physical scan, which is based on MRI, and then there's a brain scan, which works on the principle of PET scan. So PET scan generally gives you an idea how well the organs are functioning properly or not. So that's the counter that we use. That's the end of it. So this was basically my presentation of what energy medicine is and how it's impacting our lives and how we can really control it in a way that, you know, it's more like harmonization process rather than controlling in the way of controlling. It's not controlling, you're just tuning into your energy and making it the most of it, you know. And viewing health as just not the physical level, viewing health at the holistic level, mental profile, emotional profile, spiritual health, etc. Everything is taken into account, you know. So this is the counter I was talking about, electromagnetic field counter, RFI counter. Just remove your mobile phone. So what I'm going to do is basically just take an overall energy of this, you know, Dr. Mandar Adhikari. Please come here, please this side. Just extend your arms, just like this, yeah. So right now it says 188.60 megahertz. That's the frequency of his aura right now. So now what you can do is just, you know,
hold it,
yeah. So ideally the frequency should go up, you know, because what it's doing at the energetic level is transforming whatever energy that you have, absorbing it. It's like purifier, like you have air purifier, it's an energetic purifier. Usually the body takes about 30 seconds to 1 minute to, you know, get in resonance with the new energy structure, you know. So some people, like, you know, you wear stones and crystals, etc. People think that's just a belief pattern or something, like a philosophical thing that might work, it might not. But now we have a device which can actually objectively show that if it's really working for you or against you. Now, whether the body is absorbing that information to go into a state of, is it resonance or out of resonance. So this was 188.60, right? So let's take it again, extend. You can hold it, keep holding it. So it has gone to 192. So yes, there's a slight difference in the energetic part, you know, pattern. So that's how an organoid, that's how this electromagnetic fields work. With these counters, you can, this was just an overall scan, but if we can probably show the software, this is how the energy report looks like. Something like this. Thank you, yeah. So this is how the energy looks like. Yeah, so any questions? Yeah, this is organoid is basically a technology. We have given it a shape in form of a pyramid. So pyramid is also the same thing. This dome is also the same thing. This is a water coaster. This is also the same thing. This is a technology again. So depending on the purpose, we have a different layer, you know, of matrix. Now when I say matrix, it's a combination of metals, different metals, and different crystals. So depending on what is the use, we layer it in a different manner, you know. So a pyramid would be basically more of harmonizing the overall energy of the room, you know. So the effect of this pyramid would be about 5 feet. Something like this would be about 6 feet, you know. For a pendant, so, you know, even I wear this pendant because the most I can do probably is to protect myself from this electromagnetic field, you know. That's the best I can do. I cannot really, you know, install devices to shield the EMS of this room, but I can probably wear something like that, or probably in a way use some kind of therapy which is providing my body with the right frequencies, providing my body with the right information to maintain its immunity, to maintain its holistic health, you know. So that's where organoids work, where that's where PEMF therapy works. PEMF therapy is more of, you know, it's more on the healing aspects, you know. You can reverse disorders, you can heal, not cure, but heal problems with the use of PEMF therapy. Yeah. So because whatever you're doing, combined with the right nutrition, exercises, and PEMF therapy, and Reiki therapy, and meditation, etc. Just keep on doing that, because that's exactly how we treat a problem at the holistic level, you know, not just medicines. We're not saying, and I hate to use the term alternative medicine, because alternative means that something is, you know, out of the way, something is, you know, different from the mainstream medicine. What I'd like to use is complementary medicine, because it's complementing the mainstream health, you know, medical care. So if you have an issue, yes, go for the mainstream medical stuff as well, medical examination as well, but at the same time be open to the possibilities of what energy medicine can do for you, because it really treats a problem at the root level, you know, and not just the symptoms, right? Thank you.